Good morning, Medway. It's Friday, May 27th, and I'm John.
And I'm Andrew, and welcome to another edition of MTV, live from Medway TV Studios.
Auditions for next year's play, A Midsummer Night's Dream, will be held next Tuesday, May 31st, and Wednesday, June 1st, after school in the PAC. Check the call board outside the PAC for information to pick up a monologue. If you have any questions, please talk to Ms. Martin.
Members of the Archery Club were reminded to see Mr. Fogarty to get their t-shirts today. The club photo is at 8 a.m. on Monday on the football field.
Mr. Verbeem's geography class went to the Pinery and the Grand Bend. Let's check it out.
So today we came to Pinery Provincial Park to learn about conservation efforts that are being made to protect this very unique environment that we have here in southern Ontario. So they taught us about how to protect the dunes, the process of dune formation, the oak savanna, and how to protect the oak savanna and the species that live within the oak savanna. And we got to enjoy this beautiful park on this absolutely gorgeous day.
Hey guys, how you doing? Today we went for a walk on the Cedar Trail at Pinery Provincial Park. I just want to ask you how you feel about being outside on a Friday before the May 2-4 weekend.
It's a beautiful weekend. It's really sunny out here.
Yeah, it's great to not have school for the long weekend, so extra day off, I guess.
Yeah, I like it.
Okay. If you had to pick one interesting thing that you found on your walk throughout the Pinery, what would it be?
I really liked the cages, how they explained about the flying squirrels and how they can hide in them when they're just really little.
I thought that the spotted turtle was really cute, and it was just black with white spots and just, yeah.
I like the five-line skink, how it could like lose its tail and then like regrow it in like a few months. Now it's like metallic blue.
Okay, thank you very much.
Yeah.
The out of area bus deadline is June 1st. No applications will be accepted after June 1st. Please return those bus forms to the main office ASAP.
Attention all students participating in the Ultimate Frisbee Tournament next week. There will be no team meeting Monday. We'll have a practice after school next Monday.
Mr. Penny's SHSM students went on a field trip to learn about using technology in art. Gage has the story.
It's alive.
Hey MTV, today I'm here with Fred. So Fred, what are we up to today?
So you're here at 121 Studios, which is one of the co-creating spaces set up by UnLondon. We're a not-for-profit that looks at art, making tech, and you guys are getting a chance to use a tiny processor with an Arduino to aim to get things to interact with it so that you can make interactive art.
Fantastic.
We learn to program an Arduino and use it for different tasks.
To Between a Periscope. Today I'm here with Mr. Penny. So Mr. Penny,
how does this relate to SHSM? Well, the Arduino boards are very often used by artists for creative installations, so we're trying to take a look at the technology and how we can use that in the AR classroom a little bit more.
So, what is SHSM and how do students get involved?
So, SHSM stands for Specialist High Skills Major.
And it's a program that we run in senior years. So grade 11 and 12, you end up having to take 2 art credits each year, a 2-credit co-op, which has some sort of art-related workplace, and a few other courses that will have some art curriculum in it. The idea is at the end of those years, you've kind of done a little bit of a specialty, so you have a little bit more of an art background that shows up on your transcript, there's a seal that ends up on your diploma. If you're interested, you normally enroll in grade 10. So when you're going to do your course registration for grade 10, go down and talk to guidance and tell them that you're interested in SHSM. Or if you have any other questions, you can talk to myself or the state final.
Back to you, MTV.
Attention graduates, are you going into engineering? The London chapter of Professional Engineers Ontario is offering four $500 scholarships. Applications will be accepted until Friday, July 22nd from students who will be going into engineering at an Ontario university in the fall. Please see guidance for more information and the application form.
The Canadian Hearing Society Scholarship has been announced. If you have a hearing disability, please come to guidance to pick up an application. Deadline is in June.
Now, backed by popular demand, here's Ms. McKillop and more information about the upcoming athletic banquet.
I'm here to talk about the Athletic Awards Night, which this year will be Thursday, June 9th. This year we're having a catered barbecue dinner with lots of great options at 5:30. This year we're offering a team incentive, so the team with the most amount of players, calculated by a math teacher of course, will receive a monetary donation towards their program. Immediately following the dinner, we will have our awards ceremony like normal. All athletes will receive a letter in their home room, so please grab a letter and make sure you read it carefully because it's got the payment information on the bottom of the letter. Payment is done all online, so you'll have to do that at home with parents or guardians.
Please remember to return or renew your library books before June 10th.
The library will be closed after school today.
Now here's a message from Medway Student Council about what they're doing next week.
Monday is ice cream day!
Tuesday is twin day! We're identical.
Wednesday's PJ Day.
Throwback Thursday.
Friday is Spirit Day.
Well, that's all your announcements for today, Medway.
Have a great weekend. Thanks for turning on MTV and keep it PG.